Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I am Brittany Daniel. If you guys are new, then welcome. If you want to be a part of my fam, my online community, my loves, then go ahead and hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell, use hashtag fam down below so that I know it's real and you're a part of my fam. It's free, it's fun, it's lit, like Tila says. So you might as well just go ahead. I'll wait. Don't worry about it. I got time. I ain't got nothing else to do. They doing stuff. They busy, so I can wait. Okay, so today I'm going to talk to you guys about how to stop comparing yourself, okay? So this is something that I had to learn throughout the years. I have friends that are doing really, really great things in this world. And sometimes you find yourself comparing, like, my friend drives this car, my friend has this job, or my friend is doing this, my friend is doing that. But you have to run your race and live your life, because you never know what timelines are right for you that God has for you, or you know what God has for somebody else, or you just may not be ready for certain things. So you just never want to compare yourself. So I'm going to give you guys a few tips on how to help you cope and not compare yourself and love yourself for exactly who God made you to be. So the very first tip is, God made you unique for a reason. So there's a reason why you look the way you look, the way you act, the way you act, the way you think, the way you think, all of those things. Like, God made you to be exactly who you are, unless you're a twin. And even when you're twins, people have different personalities, different goals, all of that stuff. So if he made you the way you are, there's a reason for that. There's something in you that nobody else can do. There's some way that you think, how you talk, the way you can explain something, the way you can teach something, the way you can craft something. If you constantly try to manipulate yourself or make yourself act like somebody else or talk like somebody else or be like somebody else or have the things that somebody else has, you're not running your race. You're not being the best you can be. And there's a reason why God made you the way that you are. So you have to discover those things. But if you are too worried about what somebody else is doing or trying to be like somebody else, then you're never going to discover what those things are. Or you may, but it may be later in life. So the sooner that you embrace who you are and love exactly who God made you to be, then the quicker you can find out those unique talents, those unique gifts that you have. And the second tip rolls right into tip number one, but it's really like, if God wanted you to be somebody else, he would have created you to be somebody else. And I'll give you guys an example. Like, when I was on active duty in the military, like, being a black female is like, oh, you're a black female, so you have to go the extra mile to do this, and you're representing the culture. All that stuff is great, but we were constantly compared to white male counterparts. And I just came to the realization one day that if God wanted me to be a white male, he would have made me one. So then I just switched my mind and I started loving who I was, my attitude, my neck, all of that, you know, because we get in these situations, especially in corporate America, as people of color, we feel like we have to change everything we are. Of course, there's a professional side of you. There should be a professional side to everybody, but you shouldn't have to change everything about yourself to fit a mold that you think somebody else wants to set for you. I'm a firm believer in that. If it's meant for you, you will have it, and no man, no woman, nobody can take it from you, no matter how much they plot, steal, rob, lie on you or whatever. It's not going to happen, because God doesn't set you up like that. So will you let them do them, or have any preconceived notions of who they think you should be, and you do you? And so once I learned that I don't have to be like them, I don't have to be a white male, I don't have to run faster than them, I don't have to do whatever, and I could just run my race to make me happy, because my opinion of myself supersedes everybody else's, the better I was. So I want you guys to take that on. Like, if you guys are in corporate America and you think that you have to compare yourself to Susie, Lucy, Floozy, you know, okay? You don't have to be Katie in the cubicle 2 feet from you. You just be you. You be exactly who you are. If you have a unique urban name, guess what? Your mama gave you that name for a reason. So you don't have to change who you are for anybody. And I get it. As an older person, you know, fitting these stereotypes, or, you know, you don't want to be labeled a certain thing, but people's labels that they put on you has nothing to do with you. That has everything to do with themselves and how they perceive the world. That does not make it fact. That does not make it, you know, set in stone. There's a saying in the military that I absolutely hate, and it's, perception is reality. No, the hell it's not. Perception is not reality. Perception is somebody's perception. If it was reality, it'd be called reality. So don't feed into that garbage, that nonsense. And so if people have a way to feel about you, none of that matters. You just have to be the best person you can be and work on yourself every day. And don't get me wrong, don't make this an excuse to be like, well, that's how I am, and not grow. That's not what I'm talking about. Like, you definitely want to grow. You want to keep evolving as a human being and be the best version of yourself that you can possibly be. but that's not changing for other people to fit a mold or a stereotype or whatever that they think, or to take yourself so far out of your quote unquote stereotype that you feel like, because that's what they want you to do. Does that make sense? I hope you guys understand. I hope you follow me. Give me a thumbs up if you understand. Okay, so I kind of said this in number one, but you only God placed certain gifts within you, right? Like people who can cook very well, those are gifts. People that can speak very well in front of an audience without any worry, that is a gift. So Steve Harvey always says, your gifts are what you do well with the least amount of effort. That's why some people can draw very well. That's why some people can sing very well and others can't. It's just because God placed certain gifts within us. Now, when you use your gifts, you're helping out the world in any form, shape, fashion, whatever. Even if you're not being paid for it, or you don't have an arena full of people like Beyonce, that doesn't mean that your gift isn't important, and it doesn't mean that your gift won't touch the world. So you should definitely figure out what your gifts are. What are you naturally good at? What comes easy to you? And a lot of people don't even know it's a gift because it comes so easy. They think that whatever they're meant to do or their special gift is supposed to be hard, and it's the exact opposite. I'm a talker. Hello. I love to talk. When I discovered YouTube, I was like, oh my gosh, this is perfect for me because I love to talk to people, random people. I give advice to strangers. You could be looking at a bottle of wine and I'm gonna butt in my advice to you because I feel like that's my gift. I'm supposed to tell you what I know. That's neither here nor there. But you guys get what I'm saying? So whatever you do with the least amount of effort is your gift. So figure out how you can use your gift to help the world, whether it be volunteering at church, whether it be to help out your niece or nephew, your friends, brothers, whatever your gifts may be, whatever they are, figure out how you can use those gifts to help the world because only you have them, so you should use them. Tip number four is to write down a list of everything that you like about yourself. And don't focus on anything that you don't like. I don't care if you think you're too skinny. I don't care if you think you would. It don't matter. Write down everything that you like about yourself. If you're having a hard time, call a friend and ask them like, hey, what are some qualities about me that you like? Write that list down. So then anytime you're feeling down about yourself, you're feeling that you don't have as much confidence, you can look at that list and say, you know what? I am dope because I do this, 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 this. I have all these great qualities. I have a dope personality. I'm a good friend. I'm a good mother. I'm a good husband, whatever the case may be. Take that list, and anytime you're feeling bad about yourself, just remind yourself of who you are. Remind yourself of who God made you to be. Remind yourself that you are a unique and beautiful and outstanding person. But that's up to you. So you have to make that list. I'm telling y'all, it works. And tip number five on how to not compare yourself to other people. When you see somebody else living their best lives, or you see somebody else get a promotion or do something great in their lives, be happy for them. Don't be a hater. Don't be salty. Don't be like, why do they get to do that? It ain't got nothing to do with you. Their blessings are their blessings. What's meant for them is what's meant for them, and what's meant for you is what's meant for you. So if you are happy for other people, all you're doing is sending out good vibrations and love that are going to come back to yourself, because if you guys believe in the law of attraction or karma, what goes around comes around. So if you sit there and you're a hater because somebody got a promotion, a new car, a nice house, that's not gonna do anything for you. So the best thing to do is just to be happy for them. Say, girl, go, you look good, girl, or whatever the case may be. Just send out those good vibes and be happy for others, because your time will come and God will bless you with other things. And also, you never know what's on the other side of that camera. So don't ever get to a point where you're like, oh, this person has this, or this person's doing this, or they're going on a trip. Y'all don't know, once they put that camera down, if that trip was boring, if they didn't yell at their boyfriend. You just don't know what's on the other side of that camera. So don't scroll through Instagram thinking that everybody else has their life figured out, everybody else has it going on, and you don't. All you can do is focus on what you have and what you're thankful for, and just be happy for them and keep it moving. Okay, guys, well, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you guys did, then go ahead and give it a thumbs up. If you guys have any more tips on how not to compare yourself, then leave them below. I would love to know. You guys always help me out. I love you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell, use hashtag fam down below so that I know it's real, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.